Let's talk about what Sator did during the highway scene. Many of you were still confused about Sator's timeline after watching my animation of the highway scene. So I'm going to go step by step on what this bad guy did and how he get plutonium. This is not really a plutonium, but part of the algorithm. But for the simplicity, I will call it plutonium. I'm going to use my other video, which shows the whole scene from the freeway. So I recommend you give it a quick preview before watching this video. So let's start from the beginning.
Sator takes Kate to Freeport. They talk and he attacks her. It may be confusing, but then he hides next to the entrance to the red room. He has an earpiece, so he talks to his people. But he doesn't really do anything, he just waits. And he is there until his men bring Protagonist for interrogation. Protagonist said that plutonium is in a glove box in BMW.
It's in the glove box.
Sator listens to the conversation and then goes inside to kill Protagonist. But the people of Tenet interrupt him and force him into the machine. And now he inverts himself, so he began to go back in time. Fun fact, Sator doesn't really interrogate Protagonist. He already heard everything as he was waiting outside. Now he just tells himself from the past everything he knows. This is similar to why Tenet is called Tenet. Protagonist will create an organization called Tenet because Neil told him he would create one.
The Crown Operations, the Temporal Pincer.
Boom!
Yours!
Now is a great time to talk about masks. Some people in the comment section seem confused about when and why people are wearing masks. Inverted people need special oxygen. Maybe it's reverse oxygen. That's why they must use a mask to be able to breathe. But the blue room is unique and is ventilated with this special oxygen. Here, non-inverted people need masks and inverted people do not. So normal Kate uses a mask and inverted Sator doesn't. In the movie, we see that before Sator leaves the blue room, he gets his mask and takes off the mask of Kate. But let's go back to the Sator's timeline. He's inverted, so now he leaves the blue room, gets into his car and drives to the freeway. From his perspective, his people take Kate and put her in a car with Protagonist. And he searches the glove box, but it's empty. He needs to find out where the plutonium will end up, so he goes back to the car. The car drives away and after some time an orange briefcase jumps inside. Now he talks to his people. Now he goes back to the car with Kate inside and he brings the suitcase to the window. At this point he notices that there is an inverted Protagonist in another car. Plutonium jumps out of inverted Protagonist car and returns to non-inverted Protagonist. And Sator sees it all. Then he collides with inverted Protagonist and causes him to crash. He then threatens to shoot Kate, then he drives away and pulls up to inverted Protagonist. He walks up to Protagonist and says,
"Saw the handle."
He then uses a lighter to set the car on fire.
But wait, how did Sator eventually get the plutonium?
Inverted Sator was never going to get plutonium. He goes back in time and this world is deterministic, so the orange case with plutonium was destined to return to the convoy. All what inverted Sator can do is get information on where the plutonium will be. And because he saw the handoff, he knows that it will end up in SAP. And most likely he knows that this car will end up outside of the Freeport, because inverted Protagonist will drive it there.
That's why I didn't include it in my other video showing highway scenes. It happened off screen, so I'm not sure how it happened. Maybe he's communicating with one of his non-inverted men and told him to wait for the sub and take plutonium. They use earpieces and phones, so most likely they can record themselves and play it in reverse to understand each other. But I like to think Sator did it himself. He can wait for everything to go back in time, then he can safely use the machine in Freeport and wait for the plutonium to get to him. and just take it from the car. And this is Sator's timeline in the highway scene. Let me know if there is any other question about Tenet that you would like me to answer. And as always, if you like this video, leave a like. And for more videos like this one, click subscribe button. See you!